Hello student, today I am going to explain you about the remaining two pillars of the preamble, that is socialistic and secularism. Now, socialistic. In the year 1976, by 42nd Indian Constitution Amendment, Constitution of India added in the 42nd Amendment the word socialist. Most of the provisions in the Constitution of India directly or indirectly show social revolution, which brought social and economic equality and further the aim of welfare state. The principle of socialistic pattern directs social, economic and political equality for citizens as given in the preamble. It is now regarded as a prime feature of the state. It reflects the fact that India is committed to secure social, economic, and political justice for all its people. India stands for abolishing all forms of exploitation as well as for securing equitable distribution of income, resources, and wealth. Any one particular person should not have power over all assets. Instead, everyone should have equal opportunity by getting facilities and provisions from society and thereby eliminating the discrimination of rich and poor. Therefore, we can say that Constitution of India is a socialistic document. Now, the next one. Secularism. In the year 1976, by 42nd Indian Constitution Amendment, the word secular was inserted. India is a secular country. India can never become one particular religious country as per the provisions of the Constitution. India does not follow any particular religion. So the country never promotes any religious activity. The country cannot involve any secular activity with religious activity. The citizen of the country has a freedom to choose his or her religion. The country cannot discriminate a citizen on religious basis. Equal job opportunities and political rights to the citizens are given without any religious discrimination. In this way, secularism is the basic foundation and mandatory feature of the Constitution. Sarva Dharm Samdrashti and Sarva Dharm Sambhav are the principles incorporated in the Constitution. So, no particular religion would be encouraged in any states. There is no prohibition on any citizen to propagate his or her religious belief, trust, and faith. Now, children, let me guide you some short question answers based on this topic. The first one, why India is a secular state? Because the Constitution grants freedom of religion to all citizen. Next question, how to achieve the aim of establishing welfare state? The answer is through social revolution. Next question, which type of document is the Constitution of India? Answer is socialist. Next question, what kind of nation is India in terms of religion? The answer is secular. Next question, which principles are incorporated in the Constitution in terms of religion? The answer is Sarva Dharm Samdrashti and Sarva Dharm Sambhav. Now, student, in my next video, I will explain you the further topic. Thank you.